everybody. I'm so happy that you're here. This is Ariana Watts. I'm happy to call her a friend. She's the photography half of Silver Feather Studios, based out of Burlington. Her husband is Brian. He's in the back, and he's the videography half of their duo. What you need to know about them is that they are branding experts. She's been in business for 5 years, and she's been blogging since the beginning. And what that's allowed her to do is really target the clients that she wants to work with, and she's become just sort of a powerhouse in the region. So I'm going to let her take it from here. Hello, everybody. Oh, my gosh. Okay, I'm loud. Okay. I'm so excited to be here. I'm really glad that, like, there's this many people considering the weather this weekend. Like, yay. All right. Well, just a quick little bit about me because, you know, I'm up here, so you should know me. Again, my name is Ariana. I grew up in Burlington. I'm originally from Brooklyn, which I used to love. See? I used to love to tell people that. I'd be like, I'm from Brooklyn, you know, like, forget about it. And then people would be like, what part of Brooklyn are you from? That's so great. And I'm like, Brooklyn has parts? Like, what? So that always was like, and then they were like, oh, I'm just kidding. I moved here when I was 8. So grew up in Burlington, born and raised, like, based, not born and raised, but basically that's my business was here, my school was here, everything. I'm also Puerto Rican. It's very important to note that because if I talk really fast, like, whew, y'all just shut me up. but yes, I'm a wedding and engagement photographer. That's all we do, wedding and engagements, with a few exceptions for friends. You know how that goes. I work alongside my hubby. We do most of our weddings together. He shoots video, I shoot pictures. We get to be totally, like, unbiasedly impressed with each other because I can't do what he does and he can't do what I do. So, you know, that's a nice little synergy, yes. I'm a blogger. I love to shoot pictures, but I love marketing it more. So I do a little bit of writing. I like to put myself out there. I'm also, in a nutshell, a bookworm, a gamer, a chronic Netflix binge watcher, and a huge lover of social media. Holla for if you know, love Netflix. Yeah. Today, we're talking about putting the you in your brand, which is my favorite topic in life. Like, I love talking about this because I just feel like it makes your business different from everybody else's. Am I talking really fast? Okay. A little bit louder. Can y'all hear me? Okay. Before we get started into, like, the whole thing, I just want to make sure we all are talking about the same thing. So who here knows the definition of brand? Anybody? What would you say brand is?
Well, it's your brand is different than your it's how a person would know your identity when they see your logo, even.
Exactly.
Something like that.
So yeah, she's exactly right. A brand is how people see you. It's not just your logo, it's how people perceive you, how you're seen in your community, how you're seen in your website, everything. It includes who you're marketing to. It includes who you are as a person. It incorporates your logo and your colors and your packaging. But it is not just your logo. It is not just your packaging. It's not just those things. It is all of that as a whole. So because now that we kind of like are all on the same page when it comes to branding, which I should be doing this thing. Okay, we covered that. I want to go into, like, my backstory. Because, like, a lot of you here probably have been in business longer than I have, so I kind of want you guys to trust me for being like this. I've only been in business 5 years. I want you guys to trust me. So I want to talk about, like, how I got from there to here, how I'm standing up here now talking about branding, because it's why it's my favorite thing. So we're going to start with a quick overview of the whole thing. I'm going to ask you guys a couple questions, I'm going to go over my backstory, and then I'm going to talk about how we're going to flip the script to you guys. How you guys can have those same wow moments that I had in my journey, if you can call it that. And then we're going to, you know, ask questions along the way. So if you have any questions, like if you think of something you really want to talk about, you really want to discuss, make a note, because I'm going to stop and periodic and I want to talk about that. I want to make sure we answer all of your questions. So let's start with me. Just kidding. Yes. Has anyone here ever be like, why am I getting these clients that I, like, don't really like or get or connect with? Has anyone ever had that feeling? Have you ever feel like you're competing with literally everyone? You ever feel like you're in competition with like the person next door and the person who's giving away all the files and all this? Anyone ever have that problem? Okay.
Every day.
Every day. Amen. Okay. What we want is to not feel that competition. We want to not feel like we are not getting the clients we want, we're competing with everyone who's giving away all the pictures, and we just can't get our own thing. We want to build our own voice. So we're going to talk about branding and how you don't have to worry about them because you only have to worry about you. How I got here. My start of my career, my first few jobs, like I went to college at Alamance Community College for accounting. You can see how accounting, right? And then I was working in real estate. Nothing to do with photography. And then my lovely husband proposed and I got engaged, and so did like 49 of my other friends, you know, because that's how it works. Like everybody was gonna get married that year. Awesome. Well, I got to go to a lot of weddings. And back in high school, I'd taken one photography class, like one semester, college credit, what? And and I went out there and I was like, I got my Canon film camera. I couldn't even tell you what camera it is. But I went to a bunch of weddings and I took pictures for absolute fun. I had no pressure. I was just like, hey, I'm gonna shoot like this, I'm gonna get down, I'm gonna do whatever I want because who cares, I'm just having fun. And then all my cheap old friends were like, my pictures came out terrible. They ran out of film. They're too dark. I don't have this moment. And I was like, oh, that sucks. I'm so sorry. I'm going to pay for a photographer now. Like, I'm not going to make that mistake. And I happened to put my pictures on Facebook just because, again, no pressure. And they were candid. And they were in black and white. And they were film. So they had, like, a nice little touch to it, you know? And I knew not what I was doing. I mean, I shot on auto. But they all wanted my pictures. They all wanted to know, like, your pictures are so great, like we want those because my photographer didn't take any of them because it's my aunt. Well, we learned, like, right? So, those poor people, I gave them the pictures for like free, and after like literally no thought and zero research, I was like, I'm gonna start a business. Right? Isn't that the way, like, isn't that how it happens? No research, I knew nothing. Here's what I did do that wasn't terrible. I shot everything that year. I started with my bestie, my sister-in-law, bad idea. Not because, but just because we had no idea what we were doing. And so we started together, and we were shooting maternity, and we were shooting newborns, and we were shooting weddings, like we shot one wedding. And I read so much. I was reading blogs, I was researching how to sell your pictures, how much I should charge. I was researching. And at the end of that year, we both were like, she was like, I don't really want to blog. I'm like, that's not my thing. I don't want to do that. I think I'm going to pursue my own business. So that week, because we're just not on the same page. And I was like, totally. I'd rather love you than fight with you. So we split. That was fine. She was my sister-in-law. So like, this was really important. And so we split cordially. And that year, I remember it was like Christmas time. And we went to Florida to visit my aunt. And I found this one photographer. And I read her blog from the first post to the most recent. I read her entire blog, and I loved her. I was like, I'm moving to California. We're gonna totes be besties. We're gonna hang out. We're gonna watch a Glee together. She's half Puerto Rican like me. Like, I just loved her. It was Jasmine Starr, in case you didn't forget. It was Jasmine Starr. I love her. And I just loved her branding. I loved how she talked. And I was like, she's basically me. I could do that. I can use my blog to talk to people the way I talk to people, much like this. So why don't I go on my blog and like talk to people, share what I'm doing, share pictures of my trip in Florida, share pictures of what I'm doing, because I don't have any clients, like, let's do this. So I did. First year, and that was the year I went official. That was the year I count as the beginning of my business, because I went legal, I started charging sales tax, all that good stuff. 2011. During that year, I emailed a few photographers. I met some people in Greensboro, you know, got to make some friends, people who were taking me on the way. And I booked 3 whole weddings. Woo! 3. And I was like, that's not a lot, but whatever. You know, I'm getting myself out there. I'm making friends. I have, like, people who might let me second shoot eventually. Great. And I had 3 awesome weddings. I don't know. I didn't know why. They were emailing me like we were friends. They were like, when you come to the reception, like, you're only shooting till 7, I know, because that's all we can afford, but, like, stay and dance with us, because we know how much you love dancing. Do you know how they found that out? because I was blogging. They were reading my blog, and I was like, whoa, people read this? It's not just my mom. Like, great, so awesome. Like, my husband wasn't even reading it. Like, my mom was the only one who was like, oh, I saw your post, okay. So they were reading my blog. They liked me, and that was awesome. So that was a huge wow moment. That was my first wow moment, really, because in that moment I realized that was my second wow moment. The first one was deciding to use my blog. The second was realizing that people were reading it. They picked me for me. Each of those weddings, and one of those weddings was my friend, so like that barely counts, like I barely charged her, like, but she was reading my blog too. Hell, she knew more about me than she'd known me in the last 20 years we've been together. You know, like she was enjoying it. She wanted me there at her wedding. We were enjoying it. I had a friend experience at each wedding. That was my second wow moment, because I was like, I really like doing this. I want to keep this going. During that year, my lovely husband decided he was going to shoot video. He was supposed to be my second shooter. You can see how that turned out. He decided he was going to shoot video, and it was actually, you know, luckily he was really good at it. He knew what he was doing it, he was doing the research, I gave him props, you know. And we fast forward 2 years later. Back then my name was terrible. Like, it had the word focus in it. And I was like, I can't keep this name. I started with my sister-in-law, we're not the same company. My husband's doing video and it's like photography. Like, I need to make this all-inclusive. So we rebranded. We wanted to find a new company. We couldn't think of any names. I mean, we were like, Iron and Wine, oh wait, already taken. Like, we were going through all the names and we could not come up with our own name. So we looked for a company and we found one in Atlanta. They were called Brazen. We went through their blog and every time they would write about the client and then show their branding, I was like, it goes together. I knew the client and their branding and it all went together. I'm like, we want this company. And it was the only one my husband was like, it's not on Etsy, let me see. Like, all right. So he actually liked it. He actually sat down and looked through their website and loved all of their work. And so we emailed them. We took all the savings we had at that point and we hired them. And they, the first conversation, after they'd seen our Pinterest boards and like did all that good stuff, they were like, we want to talk it through. We sat down, we were both working together at the same company. So we left work, drove to McDonald's around the corner, sat in the parking lot, did like a phone conversation and had like a whole conference meeting with the whole company. And they were like, so we like your Pinterest board, we love your colors, we think you got a really good feel, you filled out the questionnaire, so like we feel like we know you. We just wanna ask you a couple questions. And we're like, what's your favorite television show? And I was like, Doctor Who. Anyone else watch that? No? Yeah, okay, sweet. I was like, Doctor Who, duh. And then the guy who was on the conference call was like, I watch Doctor Who, who's your favorite doctor? And I was like, 10, and we just had like this whole conversation. For like 10 minutes, we're talking about this television show. And then like the switch, and we were like, do you guys play video games? We're like, totally. And we start talking about video games. And I'm pretty sure you mentioned Pokemon. And like, there was so much stuff that like, half of you were going like, and half of you were probably like, oh yeah, I feel that, right? So that was the whole conversation. And at the end, they were like, great, I think we have what we need. We hung up the phone, and Brian like, oh, that was great. And they're like, wait, what just happened? Like, we didn't talk about business. We didn't talk about my clients. We didn't talk about colors. I wanted to use purple, like, do they know this? Here's what I learned from that. This was my third wow moment. They gave me a logo. We became Silver Feather Studios. Our name was great. Our name was great. We loved it. It had roots in like what actually like my name in Welsh is silver. Ariane means silver, so like that was part of it, and Brian's name means high, like flying high, not the other high, and so we're like, oh, flying feather, whatever, so that came in. Flying means, or his name means high, like the mighty, right, silver feather, silver feather studios. So like his name meant like high and flying, we're like, oh, feather, and this is going to sound really weird, and half of you are like really active, but my favorite video game is this really cool Japanese like farm simulation game, right, and to get married in that game, you give the other person a blue feather. Now here I am as a wedding photographer, and my name's Silver Feather Studios, and I'm like, yes, no one else is going to get it, but I get it. So our name became Silver Feather Studios, and then they gave us their logo, and we loved it. And we felt like it was us, and we felt like we were being like totally ourselves. And that was my third wow moment, because in that moment, I realized my brand was me and him. It was us. It was not about what we were shooting necessarily. It was about who we were as people. And that included all the weird geeky things and all the strange things that most people don't talk about. It was us, and that was my third and final moment. We built a brand and a name and a logo about ourselves, and that was when I decided I am going to start marketing this. I am going to market my dorkiness and my geekiness and my obsessions with shows and books and fandoms and using the word and using hashtags in real life. Like, I'm going to do that, and I'm okay with it. Hashtag totes, right? So that was my third rant, and I know this all sounds really random, but do you see how I got through this progression of just like, the more me I was, the better my business was, the better people I was working with, like Brazen, and the more my clients were like knowing who I was and getting into that. So now's where we flip the script. Let's talk about you. See? Let's talk about you. Your brand is made up of three big questions. What do? Who you are? And who are they? Who are your clients? So let's break it down. What do? I'm a wedding photographer, wedding and engagements. I hang out with cool couples all the time. It's themom.com. I don't want to hang out with anyone else. I don't want to shoot babies because they scare me. And they smell the fear, and then they cry. I don't want to shoot families because I don't like little people, because I'm not very good at handling them. No offense if you have kids, because like I was a kid once, but I can't deal with them. So I didn't shoot families. And I made that decision early on. Like when I was deciding after that first year of figuring out, like I knew what I wanted to do. So I could stand up here and be like, I'm a wedding and engagement photographer. Right. So who are you? What do? Are you a family photographer? Awesome. What do? You're shaking your head at me.
Newborns, high school seniors, and hospice.
All right. Interesting. So she does seniors, and newborns.
Beginning, middle, and end.
She does, okay, sweet. That's a great platform. Mm-hmm. So she knows what she does. Who here does everything? Does anyone here shoot like newborns, seniors, anybody who comes to your door?
I'll shoot anything anybody asks me to. I don't care, as long as I get to press the shutter.
Okay. But you mostly do weddings.
Yeah.
You mostly advertise weddings.
Yes.
So when you know what you do, even though you'd shoot anything, because I do shoot anything. I went to Oklahoma last weekend and just to hang out with a friend, and she had like these three gorgeous sisters, and I did a family session, which I never do family sessions, but they were beautiful, and I was like, what portfolio, right? So I did it. So I do those, but ultimately I market myself as a wedding photographer. So knowing what you do is really important. And if you do everything and you don't want to do everything, specializing is very good for you because it is really easy to market to one person, not 20. I don't have to market to mom in my business. I don't have to market to dads or children or anything but couples who are engaged. Sweet. That's very simple, and I know exactly what they like, and I know what they want to do. Speaking of which, okay, who are you as a person? What do you do in your free time? Someone give me a hobby. What's a hobby you do when no one's around?
Take care of the old people.
Okay.
Sing.
You sing. All right, anyone else? What's another hobby?
Gardening.
You gardening. Okay, I love that. Anything else? Anyone else? Anyone?
Sewing.
Huh? Sewing?
Shopping.
Shopping. I like shopping. Yeah. Right? Shopping, clothing, crocheting, gardening, cooking,
reading.
I'm a big reader. I love reading. Knowing who you are and using it to attract people is really fun. Because you know who you don't have to pretend to be? Anybody else. You just get to be you. You just get to walk up there and be like, I like reading. Look at this book. Sweet. That's it. You don't have to be like, I also am like super like organized and I do all these things and I'm perfect and professional. Like, no, you're more like, I'm really fun. Because I like books. You like books? Oh my God, let's hang out. Who are you? Incorporating that to your business is a big part of it. And it's good to know that. And I will admit, there are different sides of me. I crochet. I don't tell people I crochet. I'm not very good at it. But I do it. And I don't use it to bring in my clients because it's a different clientele. But I read, and I play video games, and I watch Netflix. And you better believe every client that walks in the door, they read, and they play video games, and they watch Netflix. It's awesome. Who are your clients? Now, this is the nitty-gritty of who your clients are. I mean, you need to know everything about them. I had to do this when I filled out that questionnaire, like, describe your target client. So let me ask you, do you know where your client lives? You probably do, because if you're local to Greensboro, you're not shooting for clients in Wilmington. So where does your client live? How much money do they make? What's their marital status? Like, you know, I'm going for engaged, you're going for children, or old. Just kidding, that's horrible. What's their marital status? What is their hobbies? I wrote down a whole list here. What do they like to do? Where do they shop? What do they do for fun? What do they wear? They wear J. Crew? Or do they go to Urban Outfitters? Or do they don't care and they make their own clothes? Like, what do they do? Knowing exactly who your client is, that you're reaching for, is really, really important because it determines what you're marketing. And if your brand is to a certain client and you know who that client is, you can constantly be talking about things that you know they're gonna appreciate. So I'm gonna describe you my target client. She's in her 20s, early 20s, fairly self-sufficient. They probably live together or have been together since high school. I got a ton of teachers, so I've kind of built that into it because I'm a big reader, so I get a lot of teachers. They live in the local area. They probably live in Raleigh, Durham, Chapel Hill. That's my target. They've gone to school at Chapel Hill. I have done 18 quadrillion Chapel Hill engagement sessions. They've gone to Chapel Hill. They like their Saturdays. And I asked them this, what's your typical Saturday? Is at home with their puppy, watching Netflix, because they're gonna go back to work on Monday. And they just like to be together. That's my target client. So guess who I market to? Only them. It's so much easier than marketing to everybody. So, what do you do? Who are you as a person? And who is your target client? Down to the nitty gritty. That's your brand. Because those three questions will make that up. But then let's talk into what we do. We're photographers, right? So that's the next part. Jasmine Starr talks about this a lot. And so I'm not gonna claim this is my original idea. But she always encourages us to pick three words to describe our business. So, and sometimes I'm choose five, but in the end it better be three because five's too many. Because you don't wanna be confused. Choose three words to describe your work. But that work should also describe your business. So my three words are spontaneous. Are you aware the TVs aren't on, Renee? Okay. my three words, can y'all hear me?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, good. I mean, I'm loud in Puerto Rican. I'm sure y'all can hear me without the mic. My three words are spontaneous, romantic, and contemporary. I'll break that down. Spontaneous. I love random moments. I love to get you doing something funny or jumping on his back or that whole thing. That's awesome to me. You see, even in the picture I chose, they just have, I told them to pose and read, and I just left them alone and they're giggling and laughing over a book. That was spontaneous for me, and that's their favorite picture and they're putting it up at their wedding. That's awesome, because that's the kind of clients I'm attracting. Romantic, I can't help it. I fell in love with my husband because he was the first guy who openly admitted that he liked The Notebook, he did. He watched it, and he wasn't trying to notebook anybody. He just legit liked the movie. That was great. We fell in love over movies. He loves movies, obviously. He's a videographer. He loves those. We love that romantic storytelling, and I read books incessantly, so I love romance. So I pull that out of my clients. I want those sweet, cuddly moments. And then, of course, emotional. And I used to have fun, but I realized that I also like crying pictures. And I like pictures where your nose is up like this. Because to me, I think it's hilarious. And I guarantee every time I watch it happen consistently, I'll be like, I'll put this picture where the girl's laughing. He's like, ha! And the girl's oh my God, I hate that shot. And then the guy always goes, why? You look adorable. The guys love that shot. So spontaneous, romantic, and emotional. And every picture I put on the internet, for the most part, better match at least two of those three words. Because that's my brand. That's part of my brand. I know who I'm targeting. I want the client to appreciate that. And every picture, with the exception of the few ones that finish telling the wedding story, there are those two, at least two of those words. I said I go over contemporary? No. I made up another word, didn't I?
Emotional. Emotional.
Romantic was supposed to be emotional, I'm pretty sure. Whatever, romantic and emotional, spontaneous and emotional. Yeah. Shut up. Yeah. Contemporary was my other one. I like to shoot modern stuff. Like, I am not a traditional photographer. I do not care about family pictures. So I'm like, bam, bam, boom, done, go. Like, that's it. And that's just because that's how I am and how my clients tend to be. And I'm like, you're not going to print those. Like, you really just need one. You can put it in an album or you can put it in your website, like on your Facebook. I'm like, that's it. So really, mom wants that. So I take it for her. I don't care. So I don't put them on my blog. I don't share those. I share it. And if I do, it's the one where all of them are looking at each other laughing. Like, I want contemporary images. And I will do. I watch, like, the first, like, 13 seasons of America's Next Top Model. So, like I love that show, right? I love that show. Sadly, it got really bad later. Like, it was kind of lame. But in the beginning and the last season was the bomb. And so I watched it. And I love to get up there and be like, smize. Like, I love that. I do it all the time. My clients love it because that one shot, they feel super sexy. And the guy's like, yeah, she's hot. And that's just validating, you know, like, just makes you feel good. So I'm okay with that. So that's where I am in contemporary, and I like to use that in my business. All right, now that I know my three words, you guys should do the same. This is all homework. My last one was, you know, what is your brand? I want you guys to start writing. I hope you're taking notes. I want you to remember, like, who am I? Like, what part of what I do I want to share with my clients? And that does include sharing your kids. If you're a family photographer, you better believe you're sharing your kids. Because they want to see that. They want to see that you're as invested in your family as they are and taking pictures of your kids. They want to see that. Write down a list of who your client is and all their demographics and where they're from and everything about them. And then, of course, write down who you are as a business. Encompassing these three words, because these three words are going to kind of motivate who you are as a person. It's going to motivate you into figuring out, like, okay, this is who I'm going for. This is what I feel is. This is the vibe. And that's going to figure out your colors and your branding and your packaging and all that good stuff. It's all encompassing. This is your brand. When you've got all these things figured out, blogging comes a little bit easier. Does anybody here have a blog? Does anyone here use their blog? No. When's the last time you blogged?
Posts on it, and that's it.
Okay. When's the last time you blogged?
Last week.
Cool girl. Blogging, this is how I like to describe it. Am I going to go into this later? Hold on. I'm just going to cover really quick. When you know all these answers to these questions, it's going to give you a lot more ideas. You can talk about common interests. You can talk about personal projects. I haven't done it in a while because I haven't read as much lately, but I like to give like updates on what I've been reading. And share books and like get them to like want to give me suggestions. Of course, my to-read list is like 493 books, but I'll get there. I like to share that with my clients. Your children, your family, your dog, they care about that.
What about recipes?
Recipes. If you enjoy cooking and find a way to kind of incorporate into where you're sharing it with your clients, go for it. I actually have a friend, and he asked me the same thing. And he was like, I don't really know, like, what's incorporated. I'm like, you love to cook, and you love your dog. Use that. He's like, what do you mean? I'm like, you had a bride. I was second shooting for him. I'm like, your bride walked up to you today and was like, how's your dog? How's your new puppy? He's so cute. They were looking, so give them more. Talk about what you cook, what you like, what you do. Write about your new recent recipe you tried and how a failure it was. That's totally okay, because then they're like, oh, she's human too. It's so cool. Do it. Don't forget about FAQs, DIYs, helpful posts for your brides or photographers. Like, go for it. They want to read that. And we live in a digital age. People go to the internet. Some of you probably still like the people who like to talk on the phone. I hate talking on the phone. I'm of that generation. But that's okay. If you're looking for clients that do talk on the phone, work with that. But also know that putting information on the internet makes people want to just come back to you, looking for those questions and answers and everything. All right, I'm gonna take a break really quick. And I want to ask if anyone has any questions, kind of about what we talked about, like figuring out your brand. Anyone have any questions about that thus far? Anything? No? Thank you. Yes?
I'm starting my business.
Okay.
I'm in school and I graduate in May, photography
Sweet.
Course. And one of our assignments in the first semester was to do a blog. There's so many things out there that you can use to blog.
Right.
picking a name was hard. I hope I'm settled with it. all those things, how do I figure out to get to where you're talking about and brand so that I don't have to worry about potentially rebranding
right.
at some point?
Right, which is what I had to do. No, I agree. It is, a big part of it is kind of figuring out what you like. Like, again, I had that first year where I was like, oh, I'm going to start a business. I had that first year just trying new stuff. Like, I did a maternity session. My God, I hated it. Because I didn't know angles back then. That was my first year. I just picked up, I just went digital. Like, I had film cameras like that point. So it's like, I don't know how to make her look good. And I'm short. So, like, every picture, she's like, eh. Like, no one wants that. And I hated it. So I don't do maternity. And to this day, I'm still short, so I still don't do maternity. I mean, I could bring a stepladder, but like, it's time for that. Just kidding. Okay, no, seriously, I'm just kidding. But yeah, like, figuring out what you like and figuring out who you want to be shooting. Because like, if you enjoy working with a certain clientele, like if you enjoy working with families, knowing that now is what's going to kind of motivate you. You want to pick a name that, even if it's not your name, it wants to appeal to families. You want to not push away. You want to be very inviting. You want to feel like a household name. You want to like kind of get them to want to sit in your house and talk and discuss recipes and healthy eating for their kids. Like, if that's what you like, that's where you start moving in that direction where you're like, okay, this is what I want to do. That's who I want to shoot. I enjoy doing that. So I want to move there. What do they like? And that's why you want to know who you are as a person. Because if I'm like really introverted and like really don't like people, it's gonna be really hard to shoot a wedding, right? So don't shoot weddings and don't advertise weddings if you're not that type of person. So it has to incorporate who you are as a person. You have to know who you are, what you like doing, what you like shooting, and then you start thinking about how to please them. And then find people, there's a lot of stuff you can learn. I mean, Instagram, you know, blogs, you can read through their blogs. What makes you click on their page? What do you appreciate about their page? Look and do research on stuff like that, because that's what I did before I decided to blog. And it wasn't until I found like one or two photographers where I was like, I want to read your blog, when I was like, this is what I'm going to do, because there's not enough of this. So does that answer your question, or is that totally like not there? Okay. Anyone else? Please? Hey, yes. I do sort of go into that a little bit. I start my blogging with the shoot, which sounds weird, and I will break that down. But yes, I do use a software. I use a program called Asana, and it lets me create my own workflows. And so I've gone through and picked up like my entire workflow of what it is. Like we're talking, select the images, put the alternate text so that they get Google search, like SEO stuff, like do all of those steps, and then publish it. And then I have and it sets it up in a calendar format if I want it to. So then I can see like, okay, I got one for Wednesday. Okay, I need something for Monday. Another thing that I do that helps me with that is I have the specific days. So like Monday is feature day. Every time I got a new wedding that like I revealed to the client the week before, which I personally, like I literally blog, client sees the pictures on Thursday, it goes up on Monday. Client sees the pictures, it goes up immediately. It's already ready. And I did that because I edited the pictures, picked up my pictures for the blog all at the same time. So having that out of my way was really helpful. And then it immediately goes up because I feel like that's how I get my clients to be like, oh, it's on the blog. I just got my wedding pictures last week. Everybody look at them. So that's part of my process. So I can kind of see and I look at my calendar. Monday's feature day. Tuesday is sneak peek day. So I did a shoot over the weekend. That's when it's going to go up because I couldn't do it by Monday. I was too lazy. I was like, I shot yesterday for 2 hours. I'm exhausted. And then I was just like, take a nap on Monday, right? So I would blog that on Tuesday. Wednesdays are personal day for me. So like anything I want to write about that's about books or me or what I'm playing or whatever, that's Wednesday. Thursday's bridal day. So like FAQs, advice. And then Friday is photographer day. So that's like business tips. So whenever I need to put in my calendar, drag and drop. All right, I didn't get this done by Tuesday, so I'm gonna move that to next Tuesday. Done. And I have my calendar, but it helps me kind of keep in mind, like I need to write something for brides. I haven't written a post for a Thursday in a long time. I blog an average of 2 to 3 times a week. So that helps me with that.
What did you say the name of that? The the blogging?
Asana. It's a program called Asana. A-S-A-N-A. Now, the cool thing about Asana is I set up my own workflow. And I researched like other people who had made a workflow and like how I was going to use it. But for you, there's also options for like 17 Hats, HoneyBook. Like, there's other options out there that are like have stuff built into it. But this one I use because I just like to have control. All right, any other questions before we move on?
So you're saying that gives you more control to do the
personally
setup how you want to do it?
Because like I make a template and then I can copy my template. And I just prefer that, whereas 17 Hats kind of has it pre-made, and then I feel like it skews my, like, there's stuff I miss.
Yeah.
And so I just prefer to have my thing. Okay. Anyone else? All right. We're going to break down marketing our brand, because that is the point of today. Like, we're going to talk about that. Notice something very specific. I did not say marketing your blog using Facebook. I said marketing your brand. And that's very important, because everything you post on Instagram should represent your brand. Everything you post on Facebook should represent your brand. Personality-wise, emotionally, whatever. It has to represent your brand. So you're not posting terrible pictures like, oh, I like this one, or random. Like, don't post something random just because. You are going to represent your brand 24/7, because that's how social media works. Like, people check all your stuff. So we're marketing our brand. You do not want to be a constant advertisement for your business. I guarantee it. Because there's this really cool button on Facebook now. It's called hide or unfollow. You really don't want that. And if all you post is, I just shot this beautiful wedding at Grayland Estate, or I really enjoyed these awesome people, they're gonna hide you because they're not getting any, they're not gonna engage with you. But if you post, I just did this beautiful wedding, and they were hilarious, and I remember when she fell in her dress, and we thought it was going to be bad, but she laughed. Oh, that's a funny story. And then you were like, oh my gosh, I've been working from home too long, and I had to go into an office today, and someone talked to me, and they were like, how are you? And I was like, good morning. And then I was like, oh, I forgot how to adult. Like, I don't know how to talk to people anymore. I've been at home too long. And I got comments on it and likes, and that was great. Because it was like me. So it's not a running advertisement for Silver Feather Studios, but it is. They don't know it. They're more interested because they're getting to know me as a person, and every once in a while I post really pretty pictures. And that's really what you want in all of your social medias. How do you talk about your clients? Do you talk about them, or are they just this really pretty family shoot? Because I know a lot of people who do this. Your blog's just a running list of this really pretty session, this really fun family, this really pretty session, this really fun family. Boring. No one cares because you're saying the same thing. So we're going to break that down because we do want to talk about how can we get a little more information. How do we avoid just writing the same stuff because we haven't, you know, we did the shoot like 2 months ago and we forgot what they look like. I hope you didn't forget what they look like. I mean, you're photographers, people. All right. Let's think. Okay. You don't want everyone to book you, right? You just want like everyone who like sends you an inquiry, do you want them to book you?
No.
Thank you. Oh, I love that you said no, because you don't. You don't want every inquiry that comes in unless they are your client. Now, there's no such thing as a perfect client, but there's definitely a thing as an ideal client, a target client. If they are super A-type personality and you're more like, yeah, you're not going to get along. If they are more lackadaisical and they like really like a person who's super organized and like on their crap, then you might be the one for them. And if you know that that's the kind of clients you get and you're advertising that client and they come to your website, great. But your website has to weed those people out. Because if every inquiry that comes in is not your target client and you gotta qualify them in your studio, in your house, at the Starbucks, it's a lot harder to tell if they're your ideal client. But if you can like weed them out with your website, if you can be like, oh, they read my blog and they did not like me, sweet. Because if everyone's booking, hiring you or sending in inquiries, you're doing something wrong. Your website is too broad. You need to hone in on who you're talking to. So we're gonna talk about that as well. Are you leveraging your social media? I love social media. I really, really, really do. There's so much engaging there. There's so many ways to like talk to your potential clients or even just random people or make friendships. Instagram is like bae. Like Instagram is the, I just said that out loud, didn't I? Instagram is like my favorite website. All right, thank you. Instagram is my favorite because there's so many ways. Hashtags are like life. Like you can use hashtags and you can, it's great, but you need to know how to leverage it. Is anyone, hold on. First off, pick the right platforms. Who here like feels like there's so many social media options? Everybody? Thank you, Brian. I appreciate your participation. there's so much social media. Guess what? You don't have to be on all of them. I am. I reserved my name, but I certainly don't use them. Like, I have Snapchat. I don't get Snapchat. And I get it, but like, it's so much work. Like, I really feel like I'm just kind of like, hey, like, nobody wants to do that. Like, that's basically what it is. And so choose the right platforms. Mine, Instagram, Facebook, and Pinterest are my favorites. And I'll break that down more, but pick the right platforms. Don't feel like you need to be on every single one. Create relationship. Oh, wait, I'm out of order. Think long term. Your goal is to create engagement, not likes. So like if y'all go to my Instagram page right now, I have 800 followers. There's like photographers who are like 15,000. Like, whoa. I don't care because I don't need 15,000 followers. I need 20 people who constantly like my pictures and comment. So when I get 50 likes on an image, yay. That's all I want, and it's consistent. I do, I get a consistent like 30 to 50 likes on every picture, and that goes up over time. That's what I want, because they're constantly engaging. I want comments. So I comment on other people's pictures, they comment on mine. There's a mutual love here, it flows, it's great. Think long term, because if you can get people to follow your page to actually book you, that's way more than having high numbers. So long term. Ultimately, you want money, right? Consider when, no, wait, let me make sure I'm out of order. Engage, yes, I talked about that. Create relationships by engaging and actually commenting and looking at other photographers and commenting on their work and looking at your clients. Follow your clients. Like, you know, I just sent out, they drove in the snow to pick up their prints. But I gave them their, like my personal gift, and it was coasters with their pictures on it because they just bought a new house with two cute little mugs. If I didn't know them and like follow their feed and know that they just bought a house, I would never thought to give them that. So, and like follow your clients and use ways to like learn about them through that. And plan ahead. If you're struggling to use social media in general, Google websites that let you schedule out your stuff. Because if y'all think that I'm on Twitter 24/7, like I ain't. Why am I super Southern today? I do not. I like that you guys are welcome to like speak up, like just hey, because that makes me feel like, you know, I'm accepted. what was I saying? I lost my train of thought. Google stuff. There are apps. Hootsuite lets you see all your feeds, and Hootsuite, 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 lets you see all your feeds and like schedule out, I'm gonna post this picture at 4 o'clock. Because I'm not at my computer at 4 o'clock. By 4 o'clock, I'm tired and I'm watching Netflix for 2 hours so I can get back to the working mode. Yes.
Does Hootsuite do Instagram?
Nobody does Instagram. Instagram has kind of put a kibosh on other APIs, like programs that you can schedule them. But there is an app called Latergram. And Latergram lets you put the picture into the app, write your comments out, your hashtags, and then it notifies you. So all you do is you click OK, open the app, it copies everything for you, and then you switch over to Instagram. It saves my life, because then my phone is just like, oh, it's 4 o'clock, post this picture. I mean, half the time I ignore it, because, you know, but it's there. And there's apps like Buffer. I prefer Buffer. It lets you sync to all your accounts, and then you can just, it shoots them out for you. It lets you even set up a schedule. So like for Twitter, it says 12 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 8 o'clock. And then I just, oh, this is funny. And I can retweet stuff from like Facebook. I can use Buffer to schedule it through on Twitter. And I can go on Twitter and I can reschedule a retweet instead of just retweeting immediately. And you tell me.
I just want to kill myself.
I was just about to say that. Some of you are probably like, what's a tweet? You don't understand. If you're into social media. It's a lot.
It's harder for somebody that's older to keep up with it, seriously,
right.
Trust me.
Fully understand that.
I totally get
what you're saying, but how can you manage it if you know you can't manage Twitter too?
That's why I was saying, Googling your program, like using apps like Buffer, take the time to, if you understand Twitter, but you don't really like it, or you understand right. Facebook, but you don't really want to be on it all day,
right.
Use an app like Buffer, because then it's just, I need to post this picture and the link to the blog, done.
Right.
Scheduled out for 3 o'clock. And then it goes out, and like 3:30, you're like, oh, someone liked my post that you totally forgot you posted.
And okay. That's Buffer?
It's called Buffer. Buffer. Mm-hmm.
What'd you call
it? Who? Oh, Later Gram? It's an app on iPhone. I think it's probably on Android too. But it's for Instagram. So, like, again, if you know how to use Instagram, but you just don't want to be on it all the time, or you know you want to post this picture, but you don't want to post 5 pictures right now, so you want to post one today and one tomorrow, which please do that. If you put 4 pictures in a row, I will unfollow you. Like, but if you schedule them out, like, I want to post this at 3 and post this one later, yeah. Because I know everybody gets off work and checks Instagram, or everybody's on lunch, checks Instagram. Plan ahead. And we'll break down more, and I would be happy to talk to you guys like on a separate occasion if you guys want, or you can go to my blog because I wrote a whole post on this, but like the breakdown steps of scheduling your post, when I post on Instagram, Facebook, like my whole workflow, we could talk about that separately. But yeah, planning ahead and learning to like kind of plan your calendar and knowing you're gonna blog on Wednesday, so you better put stuff out on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. But you don't wanna do it for 2 hours sitting on the computer, so learn how to use apps that will make your life easier.
Right.
All right.
It's also nice because Instagram also gives you the option to put anything that you're posting on there onto other.
Exactly, exactly. And I'm cautious about that though. I love it for Twitter because it's subtle, but there's no point in me following you on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter if you post the same thing everywhere.
Yeah.
So balancing it. Like I don't post every picture I post on Instagram on Twitter. But if it works, it works. If I can, and I always edit it. Like I'll, instead of like automatically posting to Twitter, I like share it to Twitter.
Yeah.
And then I can make it shorter so I know it's not gonna cut off my words.
Right.
And then like I don't necessarily put everyone on Facebook. Just because I don't want people to feel like, oh, I saw that already. I want them to follow me everywhere because then I get more numbers and it makes me feel good, right? So definitely doing that. But yes, there is ways to do that and use it, take advantage of it wisely. Yes.
One that's on Instagram that's not on anything else. I have one that's on Facebook that's not on anything else.
Exactly.
One that's on Instagram that's on nothing else. I have one on LinkedIn. I mean, they're all on different things.
Yeah.
They're not all on the same thing. So when you cross platforms, you really are crossing the market.
You are. And that's great. But you also want to make sure, because like if they're only on Facebook, then you got to kind of gear towards that. Because if I share a picture from Instagram to Facebook automatically, it's a lower quality. And it uses my hashtags, and if I tagged anyone, it's gonna say at, and it's not gonna make any sense on Facebook. So now you've kind of, it's kind of cheating, and they're not getting the full experience. Whereas if you take an extra minute, and you just get, like use the buffer, and you like put it on Instagram, and then you're like, all right, I'm scheduled this for like an hour from now, or even right now, picture, the full quality picture, the link to the post, and a cute comment that I didn't exactly say on Instagram. Well, now you're marketing on using Facebook all by itself. Your Facebook followers and the people who are only on Facebook are appreciating what you're saying. They're getting your best quality, not your leftovers from Instagram.
Sorry, I didn't realize that was like an issue, you know?
Can't go the other way.
Makes sense.
Facebook doesn't post to Instagram for you. Facebook does, okay, have you ever, Instagram never allowed APIs. They never allowed people to use other programs to post on it because Instagram was supposed to be instant pictures. Supposed to be, I took this picture right now and put it on Instagram and create this like thing. It's very similar to Snapchat, except Snapchat deletes stuff and that makes me annoyed because then I'm like, oh, dang it, I forgot to check how many people saw my stuff. It's so sad. But yeah, so like it doesn't really go the other way, but it does. Have you ever found a feed on Twitter? Like, I don't, if you don't use Twitter, fine, but like if you ever gone on Twitter and there's a feed and it's like, I posted 5 photos to Facebook. I posted 7 photos to this album on Facebook. I posted 9, and that's all it is.
Yeah.
So if you're not actually engaging in Twitter, your Twitter feed looks like crap. And you don't want that, right?
Yeah.
It, exactly, now it just looks bad. And then you look worse overall, even though you're doing great on Facebook. So it is, that's why I say pick the right platforms. Your kids are on one platform. They're only on Instagram. Your grandkids are only on one platform. They're on Instagram. There's people like that. So if you're putting your, pick two. I'm gonna do Facebook, I'm gonna do Instagram. That's it. I'm gonna move forward because I don't wanna get too, dang, how am I doing on time? All right. This is really important. This is what I was gonna mention to the young lady who asked about like my scheduling. I plan my blog when I shoot the engagement session or when I plan the engagement session. So I was going to ask you, has anyone ever had like a shoot, they see it on Pinterest or Style Me Pretty and you're like, oh my God, I want to do that. Has anyone ever had that like moment? Amen, right? Mine was lifestyle sessions. Like I was obsessed. I was like, oh, I just love these sessions where like sitting at home making like bread or making coffee and they're all cuddly and they're in their bed and it's like the really sweet thing. Like I love that. I've done two last year. You want to know why? I started shooting with purpose. I started engaging my clients and like posting stuff that was going to work with that, showing that like the more personality they were putting in their sessions, the better. So when I did that hot air balloon session, you better believe I was like, love how unique this session was. They picked a hot air balloon ride. And then we did this other session and did a blanket and had the thing. You better believe that picture was on like triad weddings and like everywhere in the world because I was like, yes, this is what I want. And the more I put that out there, the more I was shooting on purpose. I wanted clients who were like, I'm going to invest in my engagement session. Like, I really want something unique. And before long, and I would email them like, do you want to do a lifestyle session where like we're in your house and like you just pour wine and you get together and you like make waffles? And they were like, yes. So I got to do it. I did one with one client. It was all wine and glassy. And we went to like the park afterwards and it was all sweet. And I did another that was the same idea, but theirs was in their pajamas making donuts. And then they climbed in the bed and like cuddled together. It was like amazing. And I got another one coming up. It's gonna be very similar. And they're gonna do what they do. Shooting on purpose. This is all part of it. And I hope none of you guys are, if anyone's feeling lost, have I lost anybody? You following me? All right. Making sense? All right, great, great. Thanks for the reassurance, you guys. You're so sweet. There's a vicious cycle. You wanna shoot more of this. So to shoot more of that, you gotta post more of that. But you don't have it. There's nothing there to post, right? Every time you have a shoot, if you're trying to move in a new direction or if you're starting your business, you're trying to really hone in on something, for every client you get that is not your target client, take five pictures for you. Take five pictures where you do them in a pose and you angle it and they don't necessarily know it, but it's for you. And you take that shot. And guess what pictures you put on your blog? Those five pictures. I don't care about the other 20. It made them happy. Their mom ordered one and it's on their wall and whoop-de-doo. But your blog, you put your five pictures. Because the next client's looking at that. They're not looking at the ones that your clients put on their Facebook page. They're looking at you. Because that's what you're trying to do here. Yes, granted, our clients are advertising for us too. But in that transition, you blog what you want to shoot. You shoot what you want to shoot. At a wedding, even if you don't have the control, oh yeah, stand there and then be like, and do what you want. Good for you. And then share that. That's how you're going to start marketing your brand. So you're going to start figuring out who you are and drawing in clients that are for you. And like I said, share what you want to shoot. Don't be afraid. And the more you're like confident about what you're posting, like when it's your style, it's going to be real easy to look at your client because they're going to trust you. And you're like, I have this awesome idea. I love when I get an inquiry and they come for a consultation and they're telling me their life. I had this client, they came in, they were like, our typical Saturday, like we like to go to the market and like get fresh and we ride our bikes. And I was like, that is so cute. Can you imagine an engagement session where we just did that? Awesome. And they were like, that's so cool. But of course, I don't eat fresh and I don't even do any of that stuff. And we didn't hit it off entirely, so they didn't book me. But that was okay because I was like, you get up at 6 a.m.? What is 6 a.m.? Like, what? I don't believe in 6 a.m. I don't believe in anything before 7. Like, what? So, they didn't necessarily book me, but I was definitely sitting there coming up with ideas that I thought they might like, and they did like it. I hope they didn't go to another photographer and tell them that. I'd be mad. All right, let's move on a little bit. Did I cover everything? Yeah, okay. So we've talked about blogging with purpose, blogging what you want to shoot, sharing what you want to shoot, shooting what you want to shoot. Do we have any questions just thus far for that in terms of just marketing your brand? Yes?
I'm going into fashion. Like, I have an internship set up for the next 4 months.
Nice.
After school, I'm moving to New York to work with Sarah Silver, who's an incredible fashion designer. Is it beneficial for someone who's going into something like that to even really do vlogging, since I'm not really working with like general public, but I do shoot weddings on the side? Does that make sense?
Does it affect how you shoot your wedding? So you still shoot like traditional pictures, even though you're like in a fashion background, right? Okay. Do you still want to shoot weddings? Okay, so that's something you gotta figure out first. Like, if you don't want to shoot weddings, don't advertise for weddings. Don't blog about weddings. Don't take them. But if you are going to take them and you're still going to do them your way. And the only way to do that is to set your portfolio up. Like, I'm a fashion photographer. So at your wedding, you're going to stand like this and you're going to do all this cool stuff. And the client who's like, oh, but I just wanted to sit like this, is not going to book you. So it's kind of up to you. It really depends on, like, if you want to pursue wedding photography still and you want to do it more this way and you want to attract clients who are kind of into that, especially if you're going to an area like, you said New York?
Yeah.
If you go to an area, they have venues and stuff that's totally Vogue magazine, right? So if you're going for that, move in that direction. Post pictures in your sessions and your weddings that fit that and only that. If it means you only post 10 pictures from a wedding, that's fine.
Yeah.
Because you don't need to post the entire wedding.
No, I don't do that anyway.
Sweet. I love you for that, right? Like, if I scroll for like more than a minute, like, okay, my hand hurts. Oh God!
I was just wondering if that was like.
What do you
like,
do? You see what I'm saying?
Weddings, because I get along with people, but right. I'm trying to be very specific about people that I actually book.
And that's gonna come. Then you should blog, because blogging tells people what they're gonna expect. And so if they go through, and it's not just your portfolio, but there's also this blog with like a full wedding, give or take 20 pictures, right? And they see that your portfolio and this is what you're shooting.
Yeah.
Then they're booking you for that wedding to do that. And that's always good because you kind of put yourself higher. This is what you can expect. This is what I'm going to give you. And that's going to be good for you because then you should shoot weddings you want. So if that's your goal, then shoot weddings to shoot weddings you want, then yes, it is beneficial to blog. It's beneficial to talk about your fashion background. It's beneficial to talk about your journey as an intern. Do it,
cool.
Because people are gonna appreciate that about you.
Is it better to have a separate blog from your website though, or is it better to have like-
It depends on your platform. Personally, mine's the same. I've been using Squarespace since day one, and I had my website on Squarespace and everything. Eventually, I was like, oh, I'm going to do a website separately, and I hated it. I used WordPress, had someone design it, couldn't control it. And then Squarespace went to Squarespace 7, and it was gorgeous.
Yes.
And I was like, all right, we're coming back. Yes. So over time, like, I've really just keep going back to Squarespace. I personally like it. If you can get a really good WordPress website, WordPress template, it's probably the most well-known, best for SEO and stuff, but I just don't like it.
We had to create one for a project in class.
Yeah. Yeah,
so
it requires a lot more, like, a lot more knowledge, code knowledge than I'd like. And Squarespace is a little more simple. So, I vote Squarespace. Anything else? Anybody totally lost? Anybody want to, like, leave? Like, oh, deuces, see you later. All right, let's move on to websites and blogging. Your website, your blog, it is all one thing. Give her, you know, if you have that. But this is the difference. Your website is like, hi, I'm Ariana, it's so nice to meet you. Let me give you a tour. Let me show you around. And your blog is like, have you seen the latest Star Wars? Oh my God, wasn't it awesome? Right? Three times now. So good, right? That's my blog. That's what I want. Like, you guys are my clients. I can tell. I'm like, hey, we're gonna hang out. We're gonna have coffee. I'm gonna shoot your I love it. So, like, that's what my blog is about. You want people, and it, obviously, I am way more, like, some of you are probably like, I would shoot myself if I'd hang out with her, like, for more than an hour. And some of you are probably like, oh, she's cool, like, can we go have coffee? And that's awesome, because I only want one or the other. I don't want anybody in the middle. I want people who are like, she seems nice. I could probably deal with her. No, I want you to be like, oh my God, yes, or no. That's all I want. I don't want anything in the middle. So, when you think of big brands, someone's already mentioned this, but like the first thing you see is not going to be three words. Like if you go to like Coca-Cola's website, they're not like refreshing. Or awesome, better than Pepsi. Like, they don't say that. They just are that. They are better than Pepsi, okay? They just are that. So, your website is your opportunity to be your three words. There's a word that goes there. I'm not sure what it was. To emote your three words. It is not a place for you to, yeah, to like tell people what it is without saying, I'm awesome. You don't want to say, I'm romantic. We shoot spontaneous pictures. We're contemporary. You want them to go and be like, wow, this is so modern. Wow, this is hilarious. I love that shot. That's what you want. So you got to use your website and your blog to do that. That's why Coca-Cola has commercials that have nothing to do with Coke. You know, like they're about the dog or polar bear. Like they're not about Coke. Do that with your business. Use your website as your big commercial to talk about like who you are as a person. Talk about your spontaneous trips. Talk about your things that are like your romantic date with your husband. Talk about that trip to Nashville that I just took that I haven't blogged yet, but like talk about how much random that was and how much fun you had there. Talk about who you are. Let people get the vibe, not be like screaming, I'm awesome, guys. Because no one, if you have to tell people, you're probably not awesome. Sorry. Just kidding. Of course, I'm like the worst because I'm always like, I'm totes awesome, hashtag. And then they're like, oh, you are. And then that's confusing. All right. Don't be afraid to be, I write like I talk. So like, don't be afraid to be more you on your website. I'm gonna show you like a couple, like, you can see it on the screen behind me. If you can't see, I'm sorry. But like basically, it's a picture of me and my husband, reading a book, looking at each other. My nose is all, right? I love it because it is very us. It's books that I've actually read. Brian only read half of The Fault in Our Stars, judging you. But, but it is what we do. We're both fairly big readers, even if he's more. So that's the first thing people see. And then you can click the play button on my website and watch a video that's like, is very much what we do with all of our clients. So that's a great, and it's not like us, it's our clients. So that's a great way to like say hello, how you doing? Then you go in and you go to my about page. And before I click to it, I got a fun story to tell. So I had this client come in and they were like, so I hate bad grammar on websites. Like it drives me insane. Like if you can't write, like, go somewhere. And so he's like, I went to your website and I went to your about page and it was like, who he is. And I busted out laughing because you were using bad grammar to make me laugh. You were doing it on purpose. And I was like, great, because I would have been really sad if you thought that's how I talked. I'm like, but it's how, but it is. It was like funny and it made them so. Here's my about page. I'm actually going to read it to you. Don't. Some of you are not going to get it. Some of you are. That's okay. So the first thing, and this is, I'm gonna read it like I intend it to be read, all right? Hello, how you doing? Nice to meet you. We're Ariana and Brian, and we're enthusiastically in love with creating high level awesome. Little ode to my video game love, okay, high level, right? Awesome images, awesome films, awesome friends. Now, I'm not saying I'm awesome, we just like creating it, right? We're like having awesome good time. And then the first thing I'm saying is, we've been doing this since 2011. And it's the friends part that completes us, and we enjoy the entire process of getting to know you, your story, and all the things that make you hilariously fabulous people. It's our favorite part. And then I get specific. And I love this part, and I actually give this out at bridal shows. In between the editing and friend making, we have Netflix marathons because waiting a week between shows is torture, and play awesome RPG games that consume us. The latest is Fallout 4, and that changes. It used to be Animal Crossing, now it's Fallout. It's okay if you're judging me. I judge, it's okay. Want to come over and chill with us? Tell us your story and exchange pleasantries? Here's some tips and warnings. Mention John Green, Divergent, or Katniss, and we'll have plenty to talk about. Like, you know, how about that Allegiant ending? Anyone here read Divergent, right? Okay. Mention Doctor Who, and we're companions for life. And only a Doctor Who person would get that joke, right? Mention Minecraft. And if you have kids that play Minecraft, do not judge me. But mention Minecraft, and we are cracking out our game system because you're staying. Do you like popcorn, coffee, cookies? Yeah? Okay, great. Does any of that sound like any different from what I've been saying all day, like how I've been talking today since I've been standing up here? No. And when they walk in the door, it's gonna match, which is a really good thing because they're not going to my website and be like, oh, she's funny. And then I'm like, good evening. Welcome to my humble abode. Like, I'd be like, who are you? I don't want that. So, okay, branding. My website is this their first time they're getting to know me, and then they come and they get all this. And I hope they either like it or hate it, right? Finally, I'm like, you think we're kidding, don't you? Adorbs. And yes, I use totes and adorbs and hashtag bless. No, I don't say hashtag bless, but I say hashtag stuff all the time. And it usually, unironically, but every once in a while I slip up and do it on purpose and it's bad, but forgive me. quick contact, that's the boat, so we can begin. Ooh, I have a typo. We can begin the circle of love and begin creating so much awesome with you lovelies. XO the Watts. It's not different from me. It's the first thing they're reading about me. It's the first get to know me part, and it's very me. And so I want your about me pages to be you. I don't want it to say, I've been shooting since I was born, and I have a huge passion for photography. If it says that right now, change it. I'm serious, because everyone else, there's like 10 other people who probably have the exact same words. I started shooting when I was 13 because we got a new dog and he was really cute and I used my dad's camera. Okay, cool. And then I got into the business when I was older, when I was getting married. That's way more interesting. Or don't talk about photography at all. I barely mentioned it. I talked more about what I do. Because frankly, I'm gonna spend 8 hours with you on your wedding day and you better like me, because otherwise you're gonna have a really bad time. If I'm making jokes and you're like, oh my God, I wanna punch her in her face. I don't want that. I'm like, hey, totes and dorbs. And they're gonna be like, oh my God, kill her? No. No, it's gonna ruin the whole vibe here. So that's very, very important. Use your website to weed out and find your dream clients. Don't use it to book everybody. Use it to say, this is who I am, this is what I like, this is what I do, and if you like those things, sweet, let's do this. Because otherwise you're just not getting, everybody has a camera, you guys. Everybody has Lightroom. Not everybody uses it like Tracy Arney does, but everybody's got it. There's the day that you do something completely brand new that's never happened before, you must be Steve Jobs, because it's probably not gonna be like the most brand new thing ever. But you know what you got that nobody else has? What? Nobody in here is gonna stand up here and talk like this. Nobody in here is gonna have hair as big as mine. Like, all right? That's okay, because you're so all unique and all you. So that's totally okay. Make sure your website reflects that. The hardest part of blogging for a lot of people, besides pictures, because we've kind of already narrowed this down. I hope you guys have already gotten, like, you're only shooting what you want, or you're trying to shoot what you want, you're only sharing what you want. So we know what we're putting on our website image-wise. The hardest part is probably creating content. Anyone else is like, I don't know what else to write about, right?
I just feel like you're, like, I don't know, like, bragging about yourself, and that's the part I have. Someone else says something nice about me, and I'm not in the presence of it, I feel like it's true, and it's meant, and it's a compliment. They say it in front of me, I kind of question a little bit, mm-hmm. but I'm not going to say it. Like, I just feel like it's so, like, so I think that's why I have a hard time blogging.
I don't really go on my blog, though, and talk about how cool I am. I'm just cool. No, I'm just kidding. I don't go in there and I'm like, here's the reasons I'm so cool. No, I just shared that I was like, I just finished this book and I saw for like 2 hours and my husband got up and was like, who died? And I was like, this character in this book and you don't understand, leave me alone. Why did I marry you? Like, leave me alone. That's a funny story. There's a client out there who thinks that story was hilarious and they're like, oh, she's cool. I didn't scream it. And that's what I was saying. You don't have to write your blog in a way that's like, here's all the ways I'm awesome. You want to talk about your clients. You want to talk about what they do, what they like, right? So, good example, send out some questionnaires. We sent out a questionnaire with the inquiry. So, and that's mostly for my husband's benefit, because he shoots film, and because we shoot together, he needs to know our clients very well, so he can create a good story. He's all about the story. That's my job in our process. It's my job to get to know the clients and like get the stuff out of them and ask them questions. And Brian secretly records it. And then when I need to write their blog post, I watch his videos. Don't tell them that. that. But I thought about, like, that's cheating. But again, the ones where I have a questionnaire, and like I had a couple weddings where I didn't bring him along. So we didn't have an engagement trailer where like he filmed them and interviewed them. So I had to go back to their questionnaire. I was like, all right, what's their typical Saturday? What have they told me about how they met? What do I know about them? So questionnaires, ask them personal questions. All my thing is, describe a typical Saturday night. Describe a typical Saturday night. What do you do on the weekends? I ask them that. And then when I'm writing my blog post, I can talk about that. So ask them questions you want to talk about, like, how did you meet? Where did he propose? How long have you guys been married? How many kids do you have? Whatever. Describe your family, whatever you need to know if you want to write about them. And then I found, like I've mentioned Jay Starr a couple times, but I found inspiration from her. I'm not copying her. Like, by no means do anything I do anything like her, even though we're both Puerto Rican and we're both sassy and we both have nice arms. like, there's nothing I'm doing copying her, but I drew inspiration. I was like, I love the way she talks about my clients, her clients, so how can I do that with my clients? So find a photographer who you really genuinely appreciate and then be like, I love the way they talk. What kind of questions could I get from my clients so that I can kind of have the same story to tell? And then make it your own, because do not copy. It's not really flattery. It's rude. Find ways to make it your own company, your own idea. All right. Ask questions. If you're doing a family shoot, if you notice, like with Sandra, she sends out that question, like, do you breastfeed? Are you doing this? She's planning their session. She was talking about that yesterday. So if you were here for that, like, that was great. So you want to do an engagement session, or you want to do a family session, ask questions while you're there and take notes. Keep track of what they've told you about their family or what they went through. Or they went through a really hard journey having kids and how happy and blessed they are to have this first kid. Like, that's a beautiful story. And, like, the next mom's going to be like, oh, my God. I lost two kids before I had my first, and this is wonderful. If they obviously don't like post it out by asking them, but you get what I'm saying. Like, telling the story is gonna attract someone else who has a similar story. Talk about what you care about. I am not gonna blog about newborns. I don't do babies. I'm not gonna talk about like I love my niece, and I post pictures of her because she's super cute and she has my hair, but like, that's it. I'm not gonna talk about like an experience with her because I just don't think my clients are gonna appreciate it. I just happen to share like, hey, this kid didn't cry when I held her. Because my clients get that. Talk about books. I talk about books. I write about what I read. I do talk about video games. That's part of my thing. You know, you guys are like, why would you talk about video games? Like, that's childish. It's okay. Because guess what? Half of my grooms, they sure as heck played Fallout. And they were like, you played it? I'm like, yeah, I'm totes cool, obviously. Without saying it. Now they're like, both of these, I'm like, yeah, our typical Friday, like our first year we got married, we had no, what do we not have, babe? Cable and heat. So we were like, we went in our little, it was our first little house, the heat was, there was a hole in our thing, we didn't know it. So we were like in our blankets, the comforter, and we played video games like all winter. Like that was how we bonded. He had his TV, I had my TV, we played video games, we giggled, we laughed, we made popcorn, we made dinner, we ordered pizza. My clients appreciate that. That's our relationship. That's how we roll. So I want our clients to know that about us. And then they're kind of like, oh, I don't usually tell people this, but like I am obsessed with Mass Effect. Oh my God. I want that. So we use that. If you don't want that, don't use it. Right when you're inspired. I get inspiration every time I meet with a client. They come in and they're like, my friend shot my engagement session. Like, why do I need one? I'll tell you why. Because you don't know me, and I don't want to walk in on your wedding day and I'm like, surprise, hello, you know me now? Oh, I haven't seen you in 6 months. No, I want you to hang out with me for 2 hours and my husband and see him filming and how he's the quiet one and I'm the funny one and you're going to get used to that. And I say that and it makes them laugh and they like that. And I am the funny one, obviously, right, babe? I'm the funny one? Yeah, he nodded. He didn't see it, but he nodded. I want them to know that, and that's a blog post. So if I'm ever inspired or I have a client who didn't do an engagement post, like let's say he didn't do an engagement session, and then I get to their wedding and I'm super uncomfortable, that's a blog post right there. Anytime they ask a question that I've asked, I had to answer like 3 times, that's a blog post right there. Because you can email them at any time, and they're like, oh, what should I wear? Oh, here's my Pinterest board and my blog post, I wrote about it. all the time. So you can draw inspiration from your client's questions or something you're just excited about or something that happened in your life. You can talk about that. Step outside your business. I don't read photography blogs anymore. Not anymore. A, because like my work wasn't as good and I was always like, sad tie, like tear, like their work's prettier, what am I doing? But when I stepped and read blogs like Being Boss or, you know, Trend Magazine, which is a magazine I actually get to write for right now, like reading that stuff, I'm all like, healthy living, being organized, being a lady boss, that's great for me. I like to talk about marketing, I like to read about marketing, and it keeps me out of my comfort zone. It keeps me working on things that aren't necessarily just photography this and photography that. Step outside your business because it's going to motivate you to do more with your brand as a person. Read other branding blogs, marketing blogs, and like learn how to be more you and incorporate that. Be yourself. And be yourself and write in your own voice. I do that. Y'all heard my About Me page. It's corny as crap, like, but it's me, and people like it. Be yourself, write how you talk, and use good grammar, because, gosh, good grammar's great. All right, we're winding down. I just want to go over a couple more things. I got about 15 minutes, right, Renee? 15 minutes? We're good. So I want to wind down. We're going to talk about Facebook, we're going to talk about Instagram, we're going to hit up Twitter, Pinterest, and wrap this all up. Facebook's hard because the algorithms change like every 3.5 seconds. So you get 20 likes, you know, this one month and you're like, oh yay, people are getting engaged and I'm doing better. And then like next month you get 3 likes and you're like, what's happening? Here's what Facebook does consistently that doesn't really matter. You're relevant. You are relevant because you know what I do when I go to look up a new coffee shop or a new place? I go on there, I check their Instagram feed, I check their Facebook page, just see what's going on. Because it's relevant, like if they've posted in the past 2 weeks, sweet, they're like legit. I want that, I wanna like know that they're active. And the same with photography. I attended a local WPS meeting in Raleigh and they had a bridal panel and they asked her, if you didn't see someone like who had blogged or Facebooked recently, did you still inquire with them? You're like, oh no, we skipped them. Because you're not relevant, you're not active. To them, you were like, what are they doing? So if you're updating, like adding a picture to your portfolio, but you don't post on Facebook, brides today, clients today, even moms today, they're not seeing that. Now granted, you do seniors, so like that's a totally different demographic, and I have literally no idea how to help you with that. But where are they? What are they into? Figuring out what, you know, but even seniors use Facebook. Like everybody uses Facebook. I've been on Facebook since it was like you had to be in school, like you had to be in college or high school to be on it. But like everybody's on it now. I still haven't friended my dad. It's never gonna happen. But he's on it. They're a part of it. So you're relevant. People do check your Facebook page. Even if you're not getting the likes you want, at least use it to show people you're doing stuff. Client interaction. I don't post curse words or anything I'm embarrassed about on my personal page, so I always friend my clients. I don't care, I got nothing to hide. So I friend them, they can see my personal stuff, they can see my business page, and then I get to tag them. Granted, that has recently changed. You can't tag them in videos anymore, but you can tag them in your pictures a little bit easier. I know, it's a shame. So.
Say that again. You can what?
Tag them in your pictures. Like if you post a picture on Facebook, right, click on their face and tag them in it. Then it shows up on their feed. And then if they like it, which I actually have this conversation, if they like it and they share it, then it goes on their feed. Then it goes on their friend's feed. And you get a nice little progression.
You can't do what else anymore?
I can't tag in videos.
Oh, okay.
But that really only applies to us. But like it changes, but at the same time, like I'm using it to my advantage. Tag your clients. You can't get that anywhere. You can do that on Instagram, but like, you can't do that much anywhere else. So it's a great way to like visually bring them in. And pictures, videos are way better than links and basic words. A good, funny, witty comment is good, but like just the link to your blog post by itself, no one's gonna click on it. A link to your blog post with a picture, you're winning. Hashtag winning.
I can't say your name.
Yes, Ariana.
Thank you. Does it matter if you tag them, or is it better for them to tag themselves? I've heard it both ways.
I don't know. I mean, I've heard that, but to me, it's an extra step. Like, why do I have to, like, please tag yourself, and then if you don't, I'm screwed. Like, if you don't tag them, like, they don't tag themselves, like, okay, great, well, there goes that. But if I can tag them every time, that just saves me the step. And then it's like, I can share, and now I've gotten to that habit of actually sharing it to my personal page so people see it. But, like, I can do so much more than that. And again, adding them as a friend and like you book them or before their engagement session and starting to create a relationship will help with that too. But if you do want to do it the other way, it is about having a conversation with your clients. My conversation is, I'm going to post it on Monday, make sure that you share it and like it so everybody can see it because it's your day. You want you guys to like be Facebook famous. And they're like, "Toh, yeah, that's really great. I want that. You want it's extra day to be cool." Like, great. So they love it. So having that conversation with them is what's going to make a difference for that. We did that. Do I have anything I needed to cover? Oh, no, that's the next one. Yeah, okay. Good, next one. All right, Instagram. My favorite. It's so much fun. And if you're a photographer in here, it better be your favorite too. Because it's just pictures. You're not competing with anything else. You're not competing with, you know, clickbait. You know, and like people just trying to get you to like click on stuff. You're not competing with updates that are like, you know, passive aggressive. Like, you don't deal with that. It's just pictures. And guess what happens when you're scrolling through a bunch of pictures of your friends and then a really pretty picture comes up? Like, I love Instagram. Use hashtags. Market your brand using that by hashtag Silver Feather Studios, hashtag Silver Feather Squad, which I just started using because I just think it's adorable. Sounds like they're superheroes. follow others, communicate with vendors, tag your vendors. I actually recently started doing this. I send out vendor images right after the wedding, and then I go on and I post the picture and I tag them all in the picture, right at the bottom, flowers, and I use little emoticons because it's cuter. And they like that, and then they all like it, and they share it to their page because I already sent them pictures, and they're like, oh, they're cool with this, I'm gonna use it. Beautiful circle, Instagram allows that. Facebook, not so much. If you tag another business on Facebook, they may or may not see it. Instagram is very clear.
Question.
Yes.
I understand Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm old enough to be your grandmother, okay? So
irrelevant.
I understand Instagram, but I don't understand about the hashtag, these little symbols.
Okay.
Stuff, so me either.
Here's how a hashtag works.
And I'm just
so you have... This is a filing cabinet, all right?
A what?
A filing cabinet.
Right.
And in this filing cabinet, you're gonna open the drawer, and there's a file. Mm-hmm. That's the hashtag. The name of that file is your hashtag. So when people click on the hashtag, it opens the file, shows all the pictures that have that same hashtag.
So you type the word hashtag?
So you type, you know, you use the pound sign.
Yeah, okay.
Number sign.
So you use the pound sign.
Use the pound sign, and then whatever your label is. It's a label, basically. No spaces, no punctuation. Mm-hmm.
And that's it?
That's it.
And so hashtag belongs to anyone that wants to use it. So
right.
Everything would go together, right?
Right. You cannot, and like that's why like having one that's really unique for your business. Like no one's gonna steal hashtag Silver Feather Studios unless they're like stole my name. And then in which case I have a way bigger problem. So that's one good one. And then like having a couple like that. So when you click hashtag Silver Feather Studios, it's mostly my work. There's been a few exceptions, like somebody like auto-generated some, and I was like, excuse me. But for the most part, it's my work. So having one that's fairly unique, because you can't own a hashtag. But the great thing about not owning it is it creates a group. It creates feedback. Like you get people, like I will use hashtag. There's a bunch of blogs and magazines that use hashtags to find features. So they'll take a picture that you hashtag like The Knot, or like what's the Huffington Post? HP Real Weddings. And then they might take your picture and post it on their Instagram feed. And how great is that for exposure? Because they will tag you. The big ones.
You. So I took a picture of you just then.
Right.
I'm going to go to
Instagram. Or, yeah.
All right, okay.
Yeah,
so
go to Instagram.
Because I want to say.
Just put
that
little where you.
I got
the little envelope with the arrow. Won't that give you the choice?
Yeah, you could. Yeah, yeah.
When you open the picture back up.
You could also take pictures using the Instagram app. So you go in there.
I have Instagram, mm-hmm. and then I go.
You write something that people care about. Oh, so like, okay. Really enjoying myself at PP of NC with the best speaker. I'm just kidding. I'll post it later. You post that, and I'll post that about you, Dubu. I love you.
But if you go over time,
I'm almost done.
But you really are.
Thank you.
You really are.
And that's it?
Oh, it's 2:25. Hot dang.
You're
all right. Well, we'll go over, I'll help with that later. So yes, but you can use hashtag BeAStar2016. That's the PPNC hashtag for the weekend. So hashtag BeAStar2016. No spaces, no worry about your capitals, no punctuation. Boom. And anything, if you click BeAStar2016, guess what comes up? My picture from last week, my picture from today, Renee's pictures, anybody who's posted since they've been at this convention. That's how hashtags work. Do research. There are articles on, go on Pinterest and look up like hashtags and submissions and stuff. You will find blog, like a blog post that lists all the people who regram. Take your picture and post it on their feed, you know, with credit. So that you can get exposure. And if you use that hashtag, I guarantee you get more likes. I get like 20 extra likes from people I don't know when I use hashtags that are from other stuff. All right, let's do this quick. Interaction. Use hashtags, contact other people, comment on their pictures, comment on them, they'll comment on you back. I always thank a person who comments on my pictures by liking at least three of theirs. Spread your brand. Your Instagram feed should be both cohesive, like it should look nice because you're a professional photographer, but it's okay if you put personal stuff. It's okay if you start talking about who you are, promote your personality, that's absolutely okay. Here's how I do it. Try to get a decent picture with good light, because the rules don't change with your iPhone. Like, you still need to use good light and work on your shadows, right? We're still photographers. And then I talk about, it's Monday, you know, talking about this. I got this brand new mug for the client gave me from my favorite television show, Holla. A, that's a perfect example of a client who knows me. They bought me a Doctor Who mug and a tumbler, like, hello. And then I shared it and talked about it with other people. What? So that's a great example of me both showing how like more about myself, showing other people, et cetera, et cetera. Are you laughing at me?
No, I'm totally laughing. You are so adorably cute. I just have to tell you. But you're reminding me of my 16-year-old right now. Awesome.
Great.
Yeah, but she wants to see her interview that she's going to want to hire.
Yay! I get the most likes on pictures of me and my husband. Don't ask me why, but they love it. They're like, oh my God, you guys are so cute. Like, they love that. So I post pictures of us. And that's a great way to get interaction. Look at the comments that I've got, the likes that I've got. Again, I don't care if I get 150 likes or 10, but if I got comments and people interacting, sweet. I have a quick story about this one. This is a terrible picture of my bride. But you know, she knew I was taking that picture. She made that face for me. I was taking pictures like, all right, because she was comfortable with me. So I posted that. Not like 2 hours later, she posted a picture of her serving the cake, and she's like, double chin and everything, that I took of her, which I thought was funny, but I didn't put it on my blog. Like, I sent it to her. She posted it on her Instagram and was like, this is what happens when he wants to share my cake, of them cutting the cake. She's like, double chin and all. That's my clients. That's what Instagram did. I posted that, she posted her own silly picture, and she owned it. That's my clients, that's my brand. One more example before I go. I want to talk about my dear friend Tracy here. Tracy does not use hashtags.
Yes, I do.
I mean in her everyday language.
Oh, no.
Tracy does not use the word totes.
What does
I only
that mean?
Do. Totally.
Okay.
I'm like totes adorbs, you know, okay. Totally adorable. Yeah. Okay.
Sorry.
That's the one that kills me.
So sorry. It's okay. You might not book me. Tracy is very different. Tracy has a dark room background in like art and spends an hour on like one picture. So she asked me, I'm never going to go on Instagram and speak like you. I have no use for Instagram. And I was like, heck you don't.
She actually kicked.
I did. I stomped on the floor and everything. I was like, what? And I said, Tracy, You invest hours into your images, right? Mm-hmm. Why aren't you telling your clients about that? And so she changed her Instagram feed. She started posting a beautiful image, and she would talk about why she took that picture and how she took it. And so she's teaching photographers, and she's telling her brides how much time she invests in it. And guess what? Remember her? She posted one her husband didn't get. He was like, I don't get that. I don't know why you're posting that. She starts weeding out, including her own family, like, she starts weeding out people. And some people are like, that's amazing. She's getting more likes. And other people are like, I can't do that, whatever. Great, she's creating a voice. She told me today, she tripled her followers. She was posting more consistently, talking about stuff. People wanted to see more. She tripled her followers on Instagram and Facebook. She was doing the same. And she got 3 inquiries through Instagram. Through Instagram. All because she took her brand, her personality, and she used Instagram to market her brand. How's that for a great example? She's totally different from I am, but she took the same advice I'm telling all the rest of you, and it worked for her brand. Going back to our original section, who are you? What do you do? What makes you different? And work it. Pinterest, Twitter, real quick, share your blog posts, be funny. If you're gonna use Twitter, be hilarious, otherwise don't bother. Right? I mean, like, Twitter's like, you better be famous or you better be really funny. And I don't even use Twitter that much, it's not my favorite. But you can use apps to schedule out your tweets if you wanna be relevant. If you shoot seniors, figure out Twitter. Because every high school kid is on Twitter.
And Tumblr.
And Snapchat.
Snapchat.
I have the same. I'm not on the Snapchat train yet. I don't do Tumblr because I already have a blog, basically. But that's what they use. Find what they're using, at least save your name, go for that. Pinterest, great spot, great way to use personality. I post my work, I have boards for my work, my city and everything, but that's not where I get the repins. I got 2,800 followers on Pinterest because I posted a whole lot of stuff about Doctor Who and Minecraft and gaming and fun stuff and books and quotes and fun quotes that I like and book quotes that I'm obsessed with, and I know I'm going. they're like, hey, and I did that. And I got 2,800 followers just because of that, so it's okay. Because when my clients go there, that's what they see. They see my personality, and I'm okay with that. Any questions before we wrap this up?
Yes. Could you describe weeding out?
Huh?
Could you describe weeding out? You mentioned weed out.
Yeah.
What's your method of weeding out?
I'm entirely mean. If you don't like that, you're not gonna book me. I am weeding you out by standing on my website and being me on every page. This is my work. It might not be technically perfect, and it might not be everything, but it's funny, and it's fun, and there's an emotion that comes from it. And if you don't like that, and you're super traditional, and you don't see a single picture of you looking at the camera like this, then don't book me. That's what I mean by weeding out. Every page, you read my About Me page, and if you think I'm annoying, you're not gonna email me, right? So that's what I mean, is being totally you, so that people are either gonna book you for you, or they're not gonna book you at all. Yeah.
But I think it, too, it adds value to who you are.
Mm-hmm. I'm
wrapping
up.
Christ. They're not just asking you about price.
Yeah. Agreed. Exactly. Self-affirming. Because when I get an inquiry where they don't put their phone number in, and they're like, tell me 3 things about you, and they're like, blank, they're not going to come in for a consultation. So as soon as I send them that pricing guide, they're gone. Final page. Sorry. Is that okay? I'm at 233.
You know what you can do?
Yes.
We only have about a few minutes before Tracy needs to start, so I think if people want to talk to you, you can just start.
I mean, I'm done. I just was going to do my...
Okay.
Can I get 2 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay. My final question is, does it work? I've given you the Tracy Arnie example, and then I have one more where I talked to a friend of mine, and they were really, like, feeling the same thing. I was pounding into them. I was second shooting for them and at these horrible weddings. And I was like, why is this wedding suck so much? You've got personality. You're amazing. You're, like, you got this beautiful wife. Like, why are you getting these horrible brides? And I pushed and pushed and pushed all the stuff I tell you guys. He didn't listen. He didn't get it. He was like, okay. And then he emailed me exactly this. And he said, I appreciate those talks because I thought you were full of it. And then I started trying it. I was like, I'm just going to try this, see what happens. And it worked. He is so excited about next year because all of his clients are different. he was like, I started turning them away. It wasn't about money anymore. It was about who they were as people and who I was, and then I was getting better clients. So yes, this works. Tracy can tell you using Instagram for her brand worked. This guy could, you don't know who he is, but he could tell you the same thing. Know your brand, know who you are. Own it. Define it by knowing who your target client is. Market your brand. Market the whole thing, not just parts of it. Not just pretty pictures, market who you are as a person. I post pictures of them making bad faces because my clients will appreciate it because they have that humor. Own that. Allow your website to introduce and interact and repel anyone else. And finally, leverage your social media to your advantage. You're awesome. Everyone is awesome in their own way. Own that, be that. Hashtag be a star 2016. What? No, I'm just kidding.